Right, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna buy more cards, yay! Alright, hello guys, and welcome back to the second episode of Transport Fever 2 in the free mode with me, Spacefish. We're starting right back off where we left last episode, with us kind of trying to see if we can actually fill up this wood train, which would be pretty nice. I'm trying to make some more money as well, so I'm going to leave this running at triple speed, just to actually catch up on that a little bit, because next thing I want to do is I want to expand this line all the way down there to the tool factory. So, that's going to be quite a way to get the train tracks down there. It's going to cost us quite a small fortune to build that line. And then on top, we're going to need another train, which is probably going to cost us like 2 mil or something. So, I would kind of like to get some money saved up for that. Now, looking at this, this seems to be higher up, right? I'm just kind of trying to pre-plan the train tracks, but I think this is all higher up. So, it looks like this is a bit downward sloping when we go down to the tool factory. But all in all, it doesn't look like there's much of any big slopes on the way, which is really nice for our train. I think it's going to be pretty good. That doesn't look like it's going to be too expensive for trains. And we're probably going to be able to make the train quite long as well, without sacrificing much of any speed. How full is it this time? 3 empties. Okay. I think this forest is starting to produce faster and faster, isn't it? It really looks like it's producing way more than it was before. No, let's say that. It's not producing anything. Okay. There's another one. We'll have to see if this is actually, like, maybe we'll need to take some carts off or something, maybe we won't. Okay, let's see, like, this is 55 right now, 56. It doesn't really look like it's able to totally fill the train up. This is, like, okay, wow. I'm gonna leave this, like, I'm gonna keep it going for a bit. But it seems like we could probably trim that train down like 3 wagons or something at least. If we're going to do that, then it's just going to be the way it is, I guess. So, we're sort of making money. Not really that much, but we're making money. I think it just makes sense to keep this sped up for a while. Surprisingly, well, no. We're actually making a good bit more with railroad than we're making with the street kind of, with the road kind of traffic. Then again, I don't know, like, I just really want to build this line down to the to the tools factory to make a good bit more money, but I'm kind of afraid from my last experience, to be honest, of taking up loans. I just haven't had the best experience with that. I think we're just going to start by building a little cargo terminus station right here. Sorry for that one. That was my phone right there. I'm going to mute that real quick. So, let's build a quick terminus here and then see just like how expensive this is actually going to be. I'm going to put it sort of like that, I think. That does seem to make some sense. And then, let's see where we need to go. We need to sort of go like this way around. I'm going to get this map on just to make sure. It doesn't seem to be much of a slope difference anywhere. Okay. One way or another. Whoa, what was that? Okay. Let's try again. No, I don't want to stop there. Let's see. Okay, so this is more expensive because there's like some sort of slope in the way, I think. So, thinking we're going to put it like right here. And then go take a turn. Like that, I guess. And then, okay, so this is way cheaper. Like that. I'm just trying to optimize the costs as good as I can right here, while kind of also trying to account for speeds and slopes and everything, obviously. So this can stay pretty... Oh, that was... Okay, that's the sweet spot right there. Gonna take that. And then... 174... Oh, 169. I think somewhat like that. And then... We will... Oh, no. Take a long turn over here. Oh, and we're actually already out of money. Okay. Let's stop this last part of the build then. Because I actually am thinking I want to build a second track on the left of this station to kind of ensure that trains are not going to stop each other from delivering goods. Actually, we don't... I don't think we need that right there. We can probably just make a secondary... I guess... We can just make a secondary track. I kind of don't want it to block the train station. But it doesn't actually... No, I think we're just going to make it two tracks and then kind of move a second track along here. So this train can go like totally independently without having to... Ooh. Worry. It's full. Guys, it's full. That's actually good. I mean, it's obviously a matter of can it stay full. But that would mean that this forest is actually ramping up its production now because we're actually pulling so many goods off it, which would be nice. And this one, we can still just not pull all the goods off it. And we still got a little kind of gap in here. So we are gonna build, buy like three more, just like that. Gonna take them. And we're gonna assign them to Colburn Woodline. Right, this should be even more than enough to fill up the gap, though. I think it should be good. Like, it'll take a minute or two. Oh, maybe not. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4. Could probably fit like another one or two in there, but hey, it's fine for the time being. So yeah, we're kind of low on money. Game's right there. But hopefully not for too much longer. We're obviously investing in selling more stuff, so that should hopefully help. Now, when the train upgrades come, I'm not sure we actually need a new one here, because this one is pretty much just... Well, let's see. Like, maybe this forest can ramp production up even higher, and we're actually going to eventually need a new one, but... Like, right now, this seems like... perfectly timed, pretty much, so you wouldn't actually need to invest more money into a new train there. Other than that, we are just gonna need a bit more money. We're 191k right now. Deliver more, please. Yes, thanks. Oh, how's it going down here? Let's check this out real quick. So there's a few passengers here. Doesn't look like there's too many. Obviously these carts and are just everything, like every cart's just got one passenger, which is okay. Over here it still doesn't seem anybody needs to wait, so that should be fine. They're still growing pretty nicely even though the emissions here are bad, which is kind of interesting. The horse emissions aren't too bad for the city. Over here, we only have three carriages, so it's less of an issue, I guess. I hope that when this city down here grows, that's going to be less of an issue too, or else, like, I guess we can eventually just swap to cable cars and stuff like that. For the time being, that's the way it's going to be. Now, we're making money up here. I just want to make money at a quicker pace. Maybe we should take up a loan. Famous last words, right? But I'm thinking... Let's try and take, like, this much money. Let's see if it's enough. I'm thinking maybe we'll need a bit more. But I'm kind of like taking up money not only for the trains but also for the. Not only for the tracks, but also for the trains. That's the way I wanted to say it. Okay. Let me connect that up. Then we're gonna make this just go parallel, but like make it super long so they're gonna go be able to go max speed when I upgrade to better trains later. And just sort of get a build till here. Then we're gonna have to expand this station too with platforms. One, two, oh god, did I just do that? I didn't even know that was possible, but apparently it is. So yeah, just like this. What's cargo buildings all about? Street access, oh, okay. Other than that, it doesn't do anything, apparently. I'm not sure, maybe you can store more if you build those? I'm gonna have to inform myself about that, but yeah. So we're gonna expand it like this for the time being. This should be very, very fine. And now, where's my second track? It's down here. What's this? I wanna have it connect up here, please. Thanks, perfect. So we've got our station going. Now what we are gonna need is we're gonna need a line, a new line, from here all the way down here. And this is a long, 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 long way. So we're definitely gonna wanna make it full at Colburn. We are gonna name it the Wood Tools Line Colburn, something like that. I think I'll know about what it is gonna be. With our naming, that should be fine. And then I'm gonna buy a vehicle. I'm gonna have to go for the old long locomotive, sadly, which is kind of a pain, I guess. Let's see. I'm gonna make it like pretty long. I'm pretty sure we don't have high slopes, so that should still be fine. I'm gonna go and get it till like 12. Oh, actually. Okay, so we're gonna put like one less cart on it compared to the other one because we're just like out of money pretty much. And now we're gonna get it assigned to the Wood Tools Line for Colburn. What I'm actually gonna have to do real quick as well is I am going to pause. I'm gonna have to pause. I am not gonna have to do this. I'm gonna have to do this. Terminals. Okay, so the tools line is assigned to the right terminal, which is terminal 2. Oh, I could have. Okay, could have put more train tracks there. Didn't. So, well, it's the way it is. Now, the question is, how's this train gonna get there? Probably not at all, right? So, what we're gonna do? Just gonna put a few quick train. It was gonna be enough until I figured about this. Okay. Let's borrow 500k more, even though I'm like really, really hesitant to do that. But I'm gonna have to build a small bit of train tracks right there, so the train actually gets there. Like, that's kind of important, isn't it? So that should be fine. Let's get the game playing on max speed again, because we're going to need more money after this. And here comes all the wood. That's a lot. I think they've got a lot in storage too. Maybe not. But they're going to get more and more wood coming in from all these carts. So they're going to be able to produce more, and they're going to be getting more wood from this train whenever it comes. So this train's going to wait here for a second. I guess I set it to actually wait till it's full. Which means it's gonna have to wait for the second train coming from down here as well, probably, just because while we have all these carts going, and there's still a gap in there. It's incredible. It's like, it's not even a small gap. Like, I could probably stuff another 3 or 4 vehicles into that. Like, wow, okay. But yeah, we're gonna need the wood from this train for them to have some proper storage. And to be able to produce more stuff for this train. And that's an autosave right there. And there goes the autosave right there. Now, they're pretty much filling up this train really quickly, which I think it makes sense for him to at least wait until it's, like, properly full. Like, this is going to be such a long way to go till it actually sells it. But anything else would probably not make much of any sense. I'm actually kind of wondering already if this will still be profitable. I hope it is going to be. I'm just kind of worried due to the enormous length of this track. Now, this train is potentially going to be too slow to actually make us a profit. At which point we would kind of be there with a train that doesn't make much of any money and a lot of debt. So hopefully that's not what is going to be happening. Right, now what we're going to do is we're going to buy more cards. Yay! yeah, who doesn't like more cards, right? So we're going to buy 3 more, just to kind of keep it at a sensible level and just approach that perfect amount of cards slowly but surely. Just to make this like a perfect ever-going line of cards. And you see, like, this amount of wood is actually going down right now, and yeah, so their transport rate is going up, which I guess means that they're going to like allocate more stuff for us to transport to us. Because yeah, like, look at this forest down here. Like, there's actually so much wood lying around down there now, and like, my train's just coming back, so that is actually pretty nice. Like, we are fully using up all our train's capacity now. That's awesome. And this train is actually going a decent speed as well. I'm gonna try and kind of monitor the speed at which this goes, but I'm thinking it's pretty ideal. Like, it's obviously an enormous length, and it won't be able to go high slow, so I'm pretty sure it's just all down, all sloped downwards here, so we should be going a really good speed on the delivery. Whoa, and that was a little lag. I think, like, upwards, it's not really much of any slope either. Like, just look at these train tracks. Like, this is pretty much flat. Not quite, but pretty much. I'm sure we shouldn't have much of any problems. So I'm hoping, like, this thing's going 33 kilometers an hour right now. I'm hoping we shouldn't have much of any trouble making a profit off this line. Well, yeah, last year we... I hope that was due to the train waiting. I really do, because otherwise we would be in big trouble right now. But yeah, let's see about that. Right now it doesn't look too bad for the money we're making. And that's even without the profit from this train. That's like already halfway there. And I'm pretty sure that for the planks we get a good bit more money than just for the wood that we're delivering with the other train. These guys are making us a decent profit too. Like, last year we had 107k just from road, which is pretty enormous, especially considering that these lines down here are probably not making us any profit at all. Like, I mean, they're transporting like 2 people. Wouldn't, like, yeah, it's probably not going to be profitable. This one, maybe, sort of. We can actually check it out. I totally forgot. So yeah, as you can see, like, the coach lines are not making any money at all. They're actually losing us money. But I'm keeping them intentionally because in the long run, I think they're going to make us a good bunch of money just because they are going to build up that city to give us more demand for goods and thus more stuff we can sell to them, making us more money. And obviously, the bigger the city gets, the more people want to ride coaches too. So the more we can plunk coaches into the cities and make more money off that as well. And wow, did we just sell that for 1.4 million? Okay, I'm thinking this is officially profitable now, right guys? Like, this doesn't look too bad. I'm actually pretty happy about that. That's awesome. Okay, now we could go and start selling tools. I'm just not sure we're actually delivering enough wood right now. That's a worry that I would actually have. Because, like, this train's obviously going to go like 15 bajillion times faster than a train going all the way down here. And I'm actually not too sure we actually need a train down there. We could probably just move this by like another huge swarm of these carts. Then again, I'm not sure, like, these. This is actually insane. The amount of carrots we have going up there is actually insane. And there is still a gap. Like, look at this. There is still a gap. We could still pump out more. We're actually going down on the amount of wood stored right now, though, because we're actually taking it all up. So I don't think there's much of any sense in buying more until the forest produces more again. Because otherwise we're just going to drain everything and, like, this whole beautiful perfect line, well, sort of, nearly, except for the small gap, perfect line of carts getting all these goods is just going to break. Because, oh, wow. Okay. Yeah. So, we've got a whole load of these. We could get another train that goes down there, and we're actually not too bad for money either. Oh. So the upward slope is apparently bigger than I thought. Which is good to know. But still, that's fine. Every time I say that, I remind myself of this "it's fine" meme with a dog sitting in the fire. It's pretty much exactly what's going on here. Just telling myself it's fine over and over again, we'll make it fine, right? But seriously, we could probably make another line that sells this stuff. Like, somewhere in the middle, we could make a secondary, like, somewhat here, probably. Like, just here. We can make a place for the trains to evade each other. And then just get two trains going across there. That makes a lot of sense. I need more money for it, though. While we have a good bit of money, we don't have enough. I am gonna already build the tracks, because why not? With max speed, please. Just like that. Just like that. I kind of want to make it a bit longer than our longest trains are right now, just so in the future, in case, or probably rather when, we start making our trains even longer, they're not gonna have much of any trouble of the getting onto these evasion tracks. And this is not working, is it? I want to have another 120 kilometers an hour spot, please. Like, please. Oh, it's not possible. Okay. So, we're gonna kind of have to bite the bullet there. 100, 300, 6. It's just gonna be the way it is. So, considering the trains down here are going max speed, I think the way we will do this is that this is going to be the way up, and this is going to be the way down. Just to kind of not slow down trains that are already going at max speed. So this one right now is already going 40. Okay. So it's just a small spot right here, I think, that he's going really, really slow, and other than that, it's pretty fine for speed. But yeah, like, getting another train makes perfect sense here. Just look at all those planks. Like, wow. That can make us so much more money. And, like, considering every shipment apparently is $1.4 million, well, we're gonna want all of that money, right? So I'm gonna take all that up and see, like, there's still so many planks lying here. And this thing's not even upgraded yet or anything. Like, we could probably, like, once this upgrades to level 2, we can punch so much more wood into this. We could make so much money just with this one line alone. So yeah, we should expand on that. And then, I think I actually want to take care of this with, I'm not sure. I'm actually not sure. I'm, like, there's two possibilities here, right? Like, one, we could build another truck station somewhere here and just make a huge load of horse carriages go back and forth as we did before. Or, alternatively, we could have a train go back and forth, but I don't know, right now I'm thinking it's the most sensible thing to do to just build a truck stop. And if, in the future, we should need to, that's the wrong thing. If in the future we should need more, capacity, we can always build a train station on top, right? I'm just gonna have to find, like, a decent spot for this thing without, like, this is in delivery range of everything, right? It looks like it. Oh, I don't want to remove a building though. Oh, come on, this is so tight. I can probably, wait. Can I, like, just demolish this street? Oh no, that's gonna demolish that house. Okay. Whatever, then we're just gonna buy the bullet. What? Oh, there's my bus stop right there, okay. So we're just gonna bite the bullet and... Right, guys, and we're back from that short little cut. Fortunately, I just about got to save the game there. I totally forgot to save the game, and my computer was having weird issues and sort of like semi-crashing halfway through that. So, yeah, that was a scary moment, but fortunately, we have the game saved. I hope I have all the recordings saved as well, so you guys should hopefully be good when you see this. Now, looking at the recording, I've seen that we're already quite a while into the recording as well, but I've determined that I want to at least really quickly finish this line with you guys. So, we are going to go here and build that truck station we wanted to build before everything went kaboom. Put that right here, kind of as close as we can. Just like that. There goes the building. And there goes our truck stop. And now we are going to need another truck stop over here. Which I am pretty much just going to... This is still close enough. Okay. I'm just going to place it like a bit over here. Like a good bit over here. Like I'm thinking I want to expand this train station a bit. So we're going to make it as far as we possibly can. Without... not being supplied anymore. Like that. I'm gonna plunk it down there. And we've got a road depot over there. So the next thing we're gonna need to do is build a new line from here to right there. And we are going to call it tools to Basingstoke. Good thing I already named another line that way. So Basingstoke. And then we are gonna buy like no, this is like, let's start out with 15 maybe. Let's start out with 15. Oh my god, I'm sorry for that one. It seems the sounds have reset. That was so loud. They haven't. Why is it so loud sometimes? I just don't understand. Let me just get these effects down even further, because I don't know, that was incredibly loud. I'm really sorry if it was for you guys as well. I'll try and get that out a bit in post-correction. But, here are the tools. And here go all our horse carriages, hopefully. Yep, there they go. So that's going to be quite a bunch of them. And this is hopefully going to start filling up with tools eventually. Oh, yeah, they just got supplies, so it is going to fill up with tools. Here's all our precious tools, and there's like four of them. Five. Six. Okay. Well, they have a bit of supplies, right? They've got 68 there, so they're going to be producing a bit. Now, we're not going to be able to totally fill up the capacity of this, but while we're already producing tools here, we may as well use that, right? So, we're going to do that, and then I've got this here ready already. For another train to come, and we're pretty close to it, so that's definitely something we are going to be doing very soon. Now these carts are all loading up, which is not going to be lasting for too long, because sadly these guys don't really have enough supplies, so yeah, sad times, but still, for the time being, they should all be able to at least fill up once, and then after that, well, after that, they're probably just going to go empty-handed for a bit till that train is back, which is just like half the way there. If we had two trains, I'm thinking this could probably be going pretty good, and then with like upgraded trains we would probably be able to balance this out quite nicely. I just want to see real quick before we end this episode how much money we're actually going to make off these tools. Other than that, I'm also pretty interested. We're at 131, so I'm, well, population growth's obviously not going that good anymore, especially with all these emissions. Which, even more of these cards are not going to make it better. But let's see here. 6.5k. Which is, it's not that much, but you know, it's money. And honestly, like, putting a whole train line down here for that is just not feasible right now. Like, yeah, sure, we're getting these guys to produce stuff, but, like, I mean, just look at this. Is this literally just enough for one, maybe two, more like one go of, like, 15 of these horse carriages? And it's, like, 90k, so it wouldn't really cover the cost of a train. And even this way, it's probably just going to be close to a bit of profit on these horse carriages. So we're not going to be doing too great on that either until we get a second train for this line. That's going to be the game changer for us there, I think. Now, where's that second train even at? It's all the way over here still, so yeah. It's taking quite a while. We've got so many planks over here. Like, it's actually insane. One thing I want to check real quick. That's how this is doing for production. So yeah, this is still going down. So this production, this forest still needs to ramp up its production a bit before I'm going to close the gaps in between these. So that's going to be fine for the time being. Other than that, I'm pretty happy that I saved the game from that little crash I had. I'm really happy with the progress we made this episode. Like, honestly, guys, we are already at two trains. We're making a really, really, really solid amount of money. I'm still not repaying my debts because, well, I should know better, but apparently I don't. But once we have that second train line going, I think we're going to take care of that. So before we actually go for the steel line, I'm going to try and make some money to actually be able to pay off the debt. But other than that, I think we've got a nice line going down here, which is now running out of goods. And we've got that nice train line going up here, which is making a good bunch of money. Like, we're doing pretty good. Like, wood tools line, wait, wood tools line Colburn, this is going negative. Is that the wood Colburn? Oh, so that's interesting. So this line's apparently going negative, which I think is just because it's measuring it over this huge amount of a time frame, because obviously, like, we're making 1.4 million each time that thing goes in, and ever since we had it, we're making a good bunch more money, so I wouldn't trust these figures. As you can see right here, like, yes, we're losing some months, but then again, other months, we're making, like, $1.1 million, so I'm thinking we're doing pretty fine, and we will work on making that even better next episode, hopefully also with new trains. Let's see. I think some of those should start dropping very soon. But for the time being, guys, if you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to leave a like down below, hit the subscribe button and the bell if you want to stay up to date on any future episodes. As I said before on last episode, if you have any ideas for any of the namings of any of these cities, maybe also even like a forest or an iron mine or something, just let me know, and I'm sure we can get that in there. With that said, that's the new trains right there, so that's definitely going to be coming up for next episode. For the time being, guys, I'd like to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you the next time. Ciao!